नियति कृत नियमरहिताम् ह्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. इन् द वाक्यमात्रदोषाः वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द डिफ्रेण्ट् टैप्स् आफ् भग्नप्रक्रमम्. I had actually said that there are only eight. As I was reading, there is another one also he points out, which is called Akhyata Prakrama Bhangaha. That will come in the following shloka. I will take the book because it's so much easier in the text itself. Let's go to that. Okay. We look till Upasarga Prakramaha. Right, प्रकृतेः प्रक्रमभङ्गः प्रत्ययस्य सर्वनाम्नः पर्यायस्य एण्ड् उपसर्गस्य प्रक्रमभङ्गाः दृष्टाः. नौ वी विल् गो टु वचनस्य प्रक्रमभङ्गः. वचनम् इस् एकवचनं द्विवचनं बहुवचनं. वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द नम्बर् दट् ही पायिण्ट्स् औट्. काचित् कीर्णा रजोभिः दिवमानुविदधौ मन्दवक्त्रेन्दुलक्ष्मीः अश्रीकाः काश्चित् अन्तर्दिश इव दधिरे दाहमुद्भ्रान्तसत्त्वाः भ्रेमुः वात्या इव अन्याः प्रतिपदम् अपरा भूमिवत् कम्पमानाः प्रस्थाने पार्थिवानाम् अशिवमिति पुरो भावि नार्यः शशंसुः. स प्रस्थाने पार्थिवानां प्रस्थाने नार्यः पुरोभावि अशिवम् इति शशंसुः इति एवं प्रकारेण नार्यः पार्थिवानां प्रस्थाने. सो द काण्टेक्स्ट् हियर् इस् इन् शिशुपालवध. इट् इस् इन् पञ्चदश सर्ग वेर् द शिशुपालस् फ्रेण्ड्स् दोस् हु आर् आल् इन् द सैड् आफ् शिशुपाल दोस् किङ्ग्स् आर् आल् स्टार्टिङ्ग् फार् युद्धम् युद्धप्रस्थानसमये उद्यतेषु सत्सु तत्पत्नीनाम् अमङ्गलचेष्टा वर्णनम्. So it is the description of the different inauspicious things that all the ladies were all experiencing, and it seemed like a bad omen for when these enemy kings were starting for war. What were they doing? Kachit, one of them rajobihi kirna sati manda vaktrendu lakshmihi divam anuvidadhau. It was a durdinam where the clouds were all covering the sun. When if the sun is bright and shining, then it is a sudinam, whereas a durdinam is not a good day for starting any project anew. Here the divam anuvidadhau, she one lady also had, her face was very dull, it had a dull beauty. Manda vaktra indu lakshmihi, her moon like face had a beauty, lakshmihi, which was very mandam, dull. Why was that? Because rajobihi kirna, she had her menstruation, and so her face was not very prakashayuktam. This rajobihi kirna can be interpreted in two ways. One is rajaswala pushpavati, who is in her menses, or rajobihi kirna ityute, you can also say she is covered with dust, in the sense because of viraham she would have fallen down on the ground crying, and so her body might be vyaptam with the rajas, with dust. And the face has a very dull beauty because of that, as if it follows the daytime. Divam anuvidatati vidadhau, the day was also having the prakasham of sun was also absent, and it was very dull. It's as if her face was imitating the dullness of the day. Kaschid anyaha, other people, some other ladies, ashrikaah udbranta sattvaah. Udbranta sattva is their strength, inner strength. So the moment someone is going, you don't get into a confusion, and you should be very calm and steady and nice about it, and send them off, because they are also going on a war expedition. So you have to send them with a very steadfast mind. So their sattvam here means the manodhairyam. Manodhairyam udbrantam, it was absent, so they were confused totally. सो उद्भ्रान्तसत्त्वाः कम्प्लीट्लि कन्फ्यूस्ड् मैण्ड् अश्रीकाः विदौट् एनी ब्यूटि अन्तः दिशः इव दाहं दधिरे दाहं दधिरे देवर् हेविङ्ग् अ दाहम् और् अ फैर् ग्रीफ् हियर् शोकाग्नि दाहम् इस् शोकाग्नि सो देवर् हेविङ्ग् दट् ग्रीफ् इन् देर् मैण्ड् देवर् बर्निङ्ग् इन् सैड् लैक् हौ द दिशः आल् द डिफ्रेण्ट् डैरेक्षन्स् वर् आल्सो बर्निङ्ग् सि दुर्दिनम् इस् अ बेड् ओमन् at the same time another bad omen is if you find random fires in different directions it may be either because of forest fires that suddenly come up without any rhyme or reason that is a bad omen or if it is a night time or sandhya time where all these animals may be showing off their bright eyes you know in the night time when you look at animals everywhere it'll be dark with their dark bodies but their eyes will be like jwala like small fire sparks even that is a bad omen if you have hyenas just surrounding you it is a bad omen indicating death later so dishaha daham yatha dadhire tathaiva एताः नार्यः अपि काश्चित् उद्भ्रान्तसत्त्वाः मनोधैर्यरहिताः अश्रीकाः सौन्दर्यरहिताः अन्तः मनसि दाहं दधिरे सन्तापं दधिरे ओके द नेक्स्ट् अन्याः वात्या इव भ्रेमुः अन्याः सम् अदर् येट् अनदर् सेट् आफ् पीपल् देवर् भ्रेमुः देवर् रोमिङ्ग् अराउण्ड् भ्रमति abhraman they were all roaming around vatya iva like storms are also not a good omen for starting on any expedition so vatya iva like storms other people were all bhremuhu they were roaming around pratipadam apara bhubivate kampamanaha there were yet another set of people avaraha kampamanaha they were shivering at every step the moment they knew that Shishupala or their husbands are all going on a war against Krishna they were afraid and they showed their fright in their body expressed that fear that was there inside them so bhumivat kampamanaha just like the earth which shakes during earthquake they were also shaking shivering at every step प्रतिपदम् अपराः भूमिवत् कम्पमानाः इति नार्यः इन् दिस् मेनर् द लेडीस् पार्थिवानां प्रस्थाने एट् द टैम् आफ् दि किङ्ग्स् गोयिङ्ग् फार् देर् आर्मी प्रस्थानं मीन्स् ड्यूरिङ्ग् द स्टार्ट् आफ् द किङ्ग्स् इति एवं प्रकारेण पुरोभावि भविष्यत्काले यत् अमङ्गलं भवितव्यं तत् whatever amangalam is going to happen that they were shashamsuhu they indicated naryah shashamsuhu the ladies indicated the amangala that is going to happen in the future purobhavi so here atra vachanasya ekavachanam then bahuvachanam everything else is in bahuvachanam whereas the first one only is in ekavachanam it should have been kaschit kirna rajobir divasam anuvidaduhu मन्द वक्त्रेन्दु शोभा निश्रीकाः ऐ डोंट् नो हौ वै इट् इस् निश्रीकाः अश्रीकाः हि हैस् सेड् हियर् वक्त्रेन्दु शोभा अश्रीकाः केनाट् कम् ऐ डोंट् नो हि इस् जस्ट् चेञ्ज्ड् एण्ड् गिवन् अ डिफरेण्ट् पाठभेदं फार् अस् दट् इस् वचनं सो द फस्ट् सेण्टेन्स् इस् काचित् जस्ट् वन् लेडी whereas the rest are all kaschit you could have just used he could have the poet could have just used bahuvachanam for everything then there will be a because that prakramam is not maintained if or no he should have used ekavachanam for everything otherwise he can do you could have done that also but to change everything else into ekavachanam is difficult whereas you can just suggest one change into a bahuvachanam for just one thing it's a lesser change to the entire shloka so atra vachanasya sankhya vachanasya prakrama bhangaha vartate The another thing he also points out here is, if you look at all the padam, the first one is divam anuvidadhau, that is a proper kriyapadam there. Next is also dishaha iva daham dadhire. There also you have a litlakara. Anuvidadahu is also a litlakaraha. Dadhire api litlakaraha. Next is bremuhu is also litlakara. Whereas here you don't have litlakara. Kampamanaha is actually shanach pratyam here. That is why he suggests another reading, kampam apuhu. Bhumivat kampam apuhu. Then you can avoid that akhyata kramabhangam here. Kampamanaha being in shanaj pratyam, it expects kampamanaha santaha bremuhu, but you are indicating separate actions. When you are indicating separate actions and four of them are in litlakara, then one alone is in shanaj, then it gives a virasam for the sahridaya. If that had also been in kampamapuhu, pratipadam apara bhumivat kampamapuhu prasthane parthivanam, then it gives a wholeness to the shloka in all aspects. So that akhyata prakrama bangam would also not be there. Akhyatam means kriya. So kriya padasya prakrama bangopi atra vidyate. Okay. Next is akhya vachana and akhyata is over. Next one is karakam. This is a shloka from Shakuntalam in the second sarga. When Dushyanta enters Kanva Maharshi's ashram, he wants to see Shakuntala. He saw her in the first act and he wants to meet with her again. But he has come here for, he has come to that ashramam or to the vicinity of that ashramapadam for mrigaya, for hunting. Now the Senapati comes in and he says, we are all exhausted. Before he enters, he says, we are all exhausted. I really hope this king, but this king seems to be an epitome of vyayama, of exercise. And he has an endless energy and he is continuing to do this hunting every day. He wants a break. So this Vidushaka also wants a break. So Vidushaka says, you try to, protsaham kuru, aham tu, I will try to break that utsaham in him. And so they are making such plans and trying to make the king stop that mrigaya. Because king has also seen Shakuntala before and he wants to pursue her, he also decides to put a stop to this mrigaya. So he says, as an announcement, he tells the Senapati, Gahantam Mahisha Nipana Salilam Shrungair Muhustaditam Chayabadda Kadambakam Mrigakulam Romantham Abhyasyatam Vishrabdhai Kriyatam Varaha Patibihi Mustakshatihi Palvale Vishrantim labhatam idam cha shithila jyabandham asvadhanu. They are hunting for buffaloes, deer, boar, and he is also personally involved in that hunt with his bow. Now let all of this have some rest, he says. So the buffaloes, till now they would not have been immersing themselves in that waters because they have been chased around this forest. So let them rest for some time. Mahishaha Shringaihi Nipana Salilam Gahantam Nipana Salilam Muhuhu Taditam Nipana Salilam Gahantam. Let the buffaloes, Mahishaha Gahantam, let them immerse themselves into the water. Nipana Salilam. That water which is being muhuhu taditam, which is being hit frequently with their horns, shringaihi. So as they are playing in the water, they hit the waters with their horns, shringaihi muhuhu, frequently, again and again, they hit the waters with their horns. So tadrishe nipana salile mahishaha gahantam snanam kuruvantu. Next, mrigakulam, the deer, chayabaddha kadambakam mrigakulam, which has taken the refuge under the shade, baddha, have become attached to the chaya, the shade under the kadambaka, kadamba vriksha. So chaya baddha kadambakeshu, chaya kadambakanam chayasu baddhaha mrigakulani, baddhani mrigakulani. Those deer which have attached themselves towards the shade of the kadamba trees, let them अभ्यस्यतां रोमन्थम् अभ्यस्यतां. रोमन्थम् इस् चूयिङ्ग् द कड्. इट्स् आल्सो काल्ड् ऐ थिङ्क् रूमिनेशन्. ऐ एम् नाट् शुर् द टेक्निकल् टर्म् इन् सो इट् इस् चूयिङ्ग् द कड्. इट् विल् फस्ट् टेक् इन् द ग्रास् and then sit down in under the shade and then regurgitate and take that and keep on chewing it, right? So like a chewing gum. So that is the pastime of the deer. So they have not had the time to do that at all. So let them graze happily and then sit down under the chayasu, under the shade, and keep chewing the cud. Romantham abhyasyatam. Let them practice that process. Next is the boars. Varahapatibhihi visrabdhaihi varahapatibhihi palvale mustakshatihi kriyatam. Musta is a type of grass, or it is also, it is a type of root vegetable which grows in the marshy lands. Palvalam is a marsh. So in the marsh palvale mustakshatihi, the crushing of the root vegetable called musta, let it be done, kriyatam, by visrabdaihi, the fearless varahapatibhihi. We have been chasing these boars endlessly and they are always in constant fear. Now, without any fear, let the boars just according to yatecham mustakshatihi kurvantu, mustakshatim kurvantu. Mama dhanuhu asmad dhanuhu shitila jyabandham. Its jya is the bow string. It has been slackened now. Shithilam. It has loosened its tightness. And vishrantim labhatam. Let it also rest in peace. Get its rest. Let my bow also, with its bow string slackened, let it get its rest. Vishrantim labhatam. Okay. So, this is actually an atishayokti alankaram. Only after the bow rests can the buffaloes and everything rest, right? But he talks about everything resting at the same time, which is the karyakarana happens at the same time instead of purvaparyam. That is one type of atishayokti alankara. Okay. So vishrantim, we are not looking at alankaras here. We are actually looking at doshas. So let's point that out. Atra karakasya doshaha vartate. Karakasya prakrama bangaha vartate. So vishrabdaha rajayantu sukara vara mustakshatim palvale. That is the alternate reading that he says. Iti adushtam paathavedaha. Why does he say that now? Everything else, if you look at it, mahishaha iti prathama vibhakti. That is there in Prathama Vibhakti. Mrigakulam is also in Prathama Vibhakti. Whereas Varaha Pati Bihi Asmadhanuhu is also in Prathama Vibhakti. So 1, 2, and 4 padas have the Kartruvachaka padani. Whereas the Tritiya pade Karanavachaka padam vartate. That is also Karta only, but it is used in the Tritiya Vibhakti. So varahapati bihi, instead of varahapati bihi, you can take it in prathama vibhakti and say sukara varaha visrabda rachayantu sukara varaha mustakshatim palvale. That is an alternate reading that is being suggested. Generally, these alternate readings would be suggested by the commentators when they are commenting on that particular natakam or that particular work. So some of them would have found those doshas, and it has been highlighted by this alankarikas in their text to just show that you can avoid, if you can keep the meter going without any bhangam, chando bhangam, and without losing the beauty of the shloka. This is a very good patabeda that has been suggested. So it's fine. Gahantam mahisha nipana salilam shringair muhustaditam chayabaddha kadambakam mrigakulam romantam abhyasyatam visrabdhair kriyatam vara visrabda rachayantu sukara vara. That's actually a nice reading. Visrabda rachayantu sukara vara mustakshatim palvale visrantim labhatam idam cha shithila jyabandham asmadhanuh. Next one is kramasya prakrama bhangaha. Correct? Kramasya prakrama bhangaha. This is a shlokam taken from Mahavira Charitam, written by Bhavuti. In the second act, when the first act is they're all getting prepared to go to the Mithila and where the Dhanurbhangam has happened, and then the second act is the after the Dhanurbhangam. When the Dhanurbhanga has happened, as always, Parashurama is very angry about it, and he is going to go and meet Rama. When Parashurama is approaching, Rama says these words. This is Ramasya Uktihi, this shloka. Akalita tapas tejo virya prathimni yasho nidhau. Avitatha madha admate roshat munav abhigacchati. Abhinava dhanur vidya darpa kshamaya cha karmane spurati rabhasa panihi padopasangrahanaya cha. Rama is saying that when the sage has come, munav abhigacchati sati, Bhargava Muni. So when Parashurame agate sati, mama panihi, my hand is spurati, it is just waiting to clasp his feet with respect. At the same time, I have learnt my dhanur vidya just now. Abhinava dhanur vidya darpa. So I'm also very confident about it and arrogant about it. Not the idea of Rama and arrogance itself doesn't come together, right? But he says, if abhinava dhanur vidya darpa kshamaya, I feel like I have I have just learnt that dhanurvidya, and I have the confidence in my archery skills. Because of that, my hand is just waiting to show off that skill to him. And at the same time, I'm also waiting to bow down to him. Now, who is this Muni? The rest are all adjectives for Bhargava Muni. Akalita tapas tejo virya prathimni. This Muni, sage who has arrived, who has a greatness, prathima. Prathima, he has a greatness because of the akalita, unlimited, aparimita teja karanate. Tapas tejo virya. He has also performed penance. At the same time, he has a parakrama, which is akalita, unlimited, aganitam. You cannot even, unimaginable tapobalam and viram that Bhargava Muni has. And because of that, he has a greatness. It is not because of a position or anything, or because he has killed so many people. It is the tapobalam and that parakramam that he has, which contributes to the greatness in that Muni. So, akalita tapas tejo virya prathimni munav abhigacchati sati. When that sage has arrived, or when he is approaching, he is also the repository of fame. Yasho nidhau. He is like a nidhi, a heap for fame. Avitatha madha admate. Avitatha. It's not a false prestige that he has. He is admata. Admata means puffed up. Is puffed up with arrogance, madam, with a garvam, which is not vitatha, which is not false. It is not a false prestige that he has. It is true. He has shown his greatness in that manner. He has shown his darpa, his ahankara, by killing all the kshatriyas in the world. So avitatha madha admate, he is puffed up with that arrogance in his mind. Roshat, out of anger, the saha abhigacchati. Roshat abhigacchati, he is approaching me out of anger. When he is approaching me out of anger, rabhasat panihi, my hand, rabhasat, immediately my hand throbs, spurati, for what? For the confidence which is appropriate. Darpa kshama. Darpa is arrogance, or ahankara, which is kshama, which is appropriate with the abhinava dhanur vidya. And actually, the kshama is an adjective to the karma. My hand is throbbing to show an action, for an action, karmane, which is appropriate in displaying the arrogance that I have for the abhinava dhanur vidya that I have acquired. the newly acquired skill in Dhanurvidya that I have, and I have an arrogance because of that. This action that I wish to show off with my hand, that action is appropriate to that confidence that I have, that newfound confidence in that skill. My hand is waiting to show off my skill. At the same time, it is also waiting to clasp his feet. Pada upasangrahanaya cha. Now here, what is the krama bhedam? Krama is a rule, not a rule, காமிக்கிறது. Here the first highlighted quality of Bhargava Muni is tapastejaha. It is that the prakasham that he has got because of tapobalam. And then it is the viryam that he shows. Then the rosha comes only in the second pada. The first pada talks about his viram, his tejas, and the yashas that he has got because of that. The next pada only talks about his arrogance and that he is puffed up because of that admata. He is just grown in stature because of that arrogance that he has. And the roshata abhigacchati, he is approaching me with anger. So the darpa kshama karma should come only later. If he has seen the sage and he has only recognized the tapobalam first, then pada upasangrahanam should come first before anything. If it is a sage, your humility should first be there. Your discipline should first be the show, should first be indicated towards that person. It is the honor that you give him first, and then you can show your anger. Any elder person, even if you know that they are talking nonsense, you convey it in a very respectful manner. Because you give respect to their learning, to their experience, and to the age that they are. Right? So, that too, we are talking of Bhargava Muni here. I'm not very happy in showing a dosham for Bhavabhuti. But that's okay. Atra kramasya, pada upasangrahanaya iti purvam vachyam. That should have come first. So he should have said Pada Upasangrahanaya, and then Abhinava Dhanurvidya Darpakshamaya should have been indicated next. That will also be in keeping with the first and second Pada that he has mentioned. Evam Anyat Api Anusartavyam. Anyat Api, whatever you might come across in other Kavyas when you read, those also can be taken as kramabhanga. Next is avidyamanaha kramaha. The first, bhagna prakramaha, means what you have started off with, you have to end in the same manner. Here, there is no krama at all. There is no process or proper one after the other is not mentioned properly. The example he gives here is, Dvayam gatam samprati shochaniyatam samagama prarthanaya kapalinaha kalachasa kantimati kalavataha tvamasya lokasya cha netra kaumudi. We have seen this shloka before. For some dosham. Either apadastham, not apadastham. Niyatham. No. Somewhere we have seen this. Maybe avimrishta videyamsa. I don't remember. Okay. Dvayam gatam samprati shochaniyatam. This is from Kumarasambhava. In the fifth sarga, where Shiva is ridiculing Parvati's steadfast mind to continuously, you know, do tapas and try to attain Shiva. He says, dvayam gatam samprati dvayam shochaniyatam gatam kapalinaha samagama prarthanaya. Samagama prarthanaya, by wishing for a union with Kapali, with Shiva, who has that kapalam in his hand, bhikshapatra dharinaha saha samagamasya prarthanaya, prarthana karanat dvayam adhuna shochaniyatam gatam. वस्तुद्वयम् अत्र दे हव् कम् टु अ वेरि पिटियबल् स्टेट् टुडे, दीनतां प्राप्तम्. हू आर् द टु थिङ्ग्स्? वन् इस् कलावतः कान्तिमती कला, अस्य लोकस्य नेत्रकौमुदी त्वं च. वन् इस् द क्रेसेण्ट् मून्स्, यु नो, वन् कला, one portion, that crescent portion of that kalavataha kantimati kala, kalavataha chandrasya kantimati kala, that prakasha yukta kala portion, prakasha yuktaha bhagaha sa, and tvam, you who are tvam cha asya lokasya netra kaumudi, asya lokasya, you are like the kaumudi or the jyotsna, you are like a the cool moon rays for the entire world. You also have come to a pitiable state by asking to join with Shiva. That both of you are epitome of beauties, whereas he describes how Kapali is, the Sajid, the very adjective that he uses, the word that he uses for Shiva itself is enough. He himself is begging from the whole wide world. Not Daritra, but he says, you know, as a, he is, it is a representation of arrogance. See, that Kapalam is actually the fifth head of Brahma. So during that, he stands as a pillar of fire, and Shiva, Vishnu takes the avataram of Varaha avataram and goes down searching for the feet of that pillar of fire, and Brahma takes his swan and goes up. That is one of the thing. The other, and there he says that I saw you, I saw the head, and he lies about it. So Shiva takes the fifth head and uses that as the Kapalam. Kapalam is actually the skull head. There is another also that Sandhya or Saraswati is Brahma's daughter, and Brahma lusts after his own daughter, and so in order to teach him a lesson, Shiva takes off the fifth head of his. So Brahma was supposed to have had five heads, and this Kapalam is the representation of that arrogance, that, you know, you give your arrogance to Shiva and he has it in his hand, then you can let go of it. That is the whole idea. But on a very, in order to, you know, sway Parvati away from her resolve, Shiva himself ridicules himself. So Kapalinaha Samagama Prarthanaya, by wishing to join with the Bhikshapatra Dhari, both of you have come to a very pitiable state. One is the Chandra's crescent, that part, and you who are like the rays, moon rays for the entire world. You're such a beautiful person. Why do you have to wish to be with him? Atra Thvam Shabdanantaram Chakaraha Yuktaha. Okay. So it's very simple, because Kalacha Sakantimati Kalavataha Thvam Cha Lokasyasya Netra Kaumudi. You and that kala, in order to understand tvam cha, you also, and that can give that idea only if that cha is mentioned next to tvam. Otherwise, that samuchyartha dyotanam tvam will be absent. Samuchyartha means along with that, it will be absent. Both of you, in order to indicate both, you should say he and her. That and should be beside the two nouns. Because that is not present, it is a dosha. Some people say that cha is not in the place that it has to be there. So it is actually a apagastha pada doshaha, nato akrama doshaha. It can't. So there is a dispute in this. Some vyakhyatas say this is actually not akrama dosha, it is apadastha pada dosha. Some say that it is a krama dosha, where kramena, it has, this is how the words should be. If that is not there, then there is a dosha. That's why he gives another example. Shaktir nistrimsha jeyam तव भुज युगले नाथ दोषाकरश्रीः वक्त्रे पार्श्वे ततैषा प्रतिवसति महाकुट्टनी खड्गयष्टिः आज्ञेयं सर्वगाते विलसति च पुरः किं मया वृद्धयाते प्रोच्य इव इत्थं प्रकोपात् शशिकरसितया यस्य कीर्त्या प्रयातम्. वेरि nice image. Remember that shloka where we had Lakshmi wanted to complain to her father and she sent the kirti to her father to complain about the asiyashti. It's a very similar thing here. It is not Lakshmi which is the patni here, it is kirti herself is the patni for the raja. So kirti is like the patni, sat patni, and asiyashti Khadgayashti. Khadgayashti is the Mahakuttani. She is like a Veshyastri. So she is the Aparanayika, Mahakuttani sa. And the Kirti is the Patni here. She gets very angry. Fame gets very angry on seeing the sword always in the king's hand. So she goes and says, you know, now that you have the Asiyashti in your hand, she is very well experienced. She will dance to your tunes. So what is the use for such an old person like me? Maya vriddhaya te kim. Puraha maya vriddhaya te kim. Iti prachya iva. As if she is saying that. Itham prachya iva. As if the Kirti is saying all of these things, she goes far. Yasya Kirti Prayatam. His Kirti, Yasya Kirtya, the Rajnyaha Kirtya, Yashasa, Prayatam, Duram Prayatam. It went off somewhere far. How Prakopat, Shashikara Sitaya Kirtya, Yasya Kirtya, Ittham prochya iva, uchya iva, after uktva prochya, with the pra upasargam, it becomes lyap. So prochya iva, after saying thus, prakopat, with anger, yasya kirtya, the king's fame, which is shashikara sitaya, which is very white, like the rays of the moon, white fame. Prayatam, it left. What did it say? Let's see that. 1 minute. Okay. Shaktihi nistrimshaja iyam shaktihi tava bhuja yugale, in your two hands, iyam shaktihi, this great power, which is khadgayashti. Everything is an adjective to that khadgayashti. So this strength that comes from that the cruel one, nistrimshaja, nistrimsha is cruel person. And from cruelty, this strength which is born out of cruelty, that is present in the khadgayashti, shakti yukta asti. So that khadgayashti is very much like a strength that is present in your bhuja yugale, he natha. That shakti is also doshakara shrihi, dosha akara shrihi. It is filled with, it is like an akara, repository of dosha, of all bad things, because it kills so much. It has a great sampat, akara shrihi. It is a repository of this wealth called dosham. Vaktre parshve, vaktre, tatha yesha prativasati. It is always constantly near your face. Mahakuttani, it is capable of cutting in a great manner. Mahakuttam, kuttam means chinatti iti. So it is capable of cutting in a very profusely. It can cut in a very great manner. So vaktre parshve means it is constantly near your face, which you're raising your hand, that khadgayashti always. So if the hand is raised with that khadgam, it is present near the face always. It is not inside the cover, the scabbard. It is not inside the kosha, and it is always, he is brandishing it outside. So, vaktre parshve tatha esha, it is right in the face and it is also very close by, nearby. Prativasati, it is constantly living, this khadga yashti. Iyam sarvaga, it goes everywhere. Te agnya, it is a personification of your agnya, your order. So, the moment you think, whatever you order, it will go in front of you. Sarvaga, it goes everywhere. Te puraha cha vilasati, it also prakashate, it shines in front of you. Maya vriddhaya te kim, tava kim prayojanam. What is the use of me who is very old? So he has been having that fame for such a long time that Kirti is like an old lady. Then this Anga Yashti is like a very young lady who is willing to do whatever he wants and dances in front of him and all that. So every adjective is now going to go to a Veshya Stri also. So Shaktihi, she has a great strength. Nistrim Shaja, she also is the Dhurta Putri. Nistrim Shaha is a cruel person. There is another meaning also to it. It's too, what to say? I mean, Nistrimsha means Nirgata, Trimsha means that Trimshataha Adhikam Ityuktam. So for a sword, it is more than 30 finger length. If you place 30 fingers and it is beyond a 30 finger length, that is one meaning for that Trimsha, Nistrimshaja. The meaning for a Veshya Stri is she has more than 30 fathers. In the sense, she is a Veshya Putri Cha. So that is also another meaning. I prefer the Nistrimsha also has another cruelty is another meaning. So we will take it as Nirghrinaja. And Nirghrinaha ityukte dhurtaha khalaha khalasya putri ityapi uktum shakyate. So tadrisha yam tava bhuja yugale, who is ever embracing you, dosha akara shrihi, she is a repository of all dosha. The moment you have a sangam with the Veshya Stri, everything else comes down. Your wealth, your friends move away from you, so many bad things start coming. So she is like a repository of dosha. Vaktre parshve tataiva prativasati, she always approaches very close by. She is proudha. So she comes nearby and she stands near the face and she can talk straight to the face. She can approach closely without any shyness at all. Mahakuttani. Mahakuttani is Veshya. Khadga Yashtihi. Of course, Khadga Yashti goes only for the sword. Agnya Iyam Sarvaga. Sarvaga, she goes everywhere. Wherever you want to go, she has no inhibitions, whether it is Darbar or anywhere. Wherever the king wants to go, the Veshya Stri also has no inhibitions about going. And Agnya cha, she follows every order of yours. Puraha Vilasati, she stands in front of you and Prakashate. What is the use of me? I am, after all, a patni who has been with you for a long time and I am a vriddha. I am old. Itam prochya iva, as if to say thus, the Kirtya, fame went off in anger. Prakopat. Now, atra ittam prochya iva iti nyayam. That is what should have been present here. Instead of prochyevetham, prochya iva ittam, instead of that ittam should have come before. That is the kramam. That is how it should have been said. Okay. Another example he gives is that the same lakshana solluma.
The anvayam eppadi varudhu indha shlokathukku? Just generally the yasya kitya prayatam vandu
inga yasya shashi kara sitaya kirtya itham prochya iva prakopatu prayatam.
Oh, prayatam. Okay, prayatathoda
mudiyudhu. Prayatam dhaan verb inga. Okay. That is your kriyapadam. Kirtya prayatam aasithu. Kirtihi prayatam.
Yasya enga poi mudiyaradhu.
Yasya vandhu raja. Raja avanudiyadhu. सो राज्ञः कीर्त्या एवं प्रयातम् என்ன சோ எஸ்யக்கு தஸ்ய இல்லையேங்கிறியா
அந்த மாதிரி
அது தட் தஸ்ய ராஜ்ஞிய நமஹான்னுட்டு ஆரம்பத்துல இருக்குமா இருக்கும்
சி ஓகே அந்த கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் பேஸ் பண்ணி நமக்கு தெரியும்
இட்ஸ் மோர் ஆஃப் அ கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் பேஸ்ட் சோ இந்த கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் இட் குட் ஹவ் ஸ்டார்டட் யோயம் ராஜ்ஞஹ யோயம் ராஜா ஆர் தஸ்ய ராஜ்ஞஹ எஸ்ய கீர்த்தியா பிரயாதம் தட் கேன் பி ஆர் தஸ்மை ராஜ்ஞே நமஹ it could be like that. So these are all isolated shlokas. If you take it as isolated shlokas also, a kavi can say this shloka, yasya kirtya prayatam tasmai rajnya namaha. He can say tasmai namaha. And he can finish off his isolated shloka also. Tatha, in the same manner, he is giving another shloka, the one we had before also, where the garbhitam shlokam we saw. Lagnam raga vritangya. Can I just go to that 1 minute? Garbhitam kena. And the Shri Niyogat Lakshmi Shloka. Where that Kirti goes to that Samudram and complains. No, Lakshmi complains to that, to her father. Peeta. No. One more. Ah. लग्नं रागावृताङ्ग्या सुदृढमिह यया एव असियष्ट्या अरिकण्ठे मातङ्गानाम् अपि इह उपरि परपुरुषैः या च दृष्टा पतन्ति द सेम् ऐडिया दट् वी सा जस्ट् लास्ट् क्लास् यस्टर्डेस् क्लास् आर् द क्लास् बिफोर् तत्सक्तोऽयं न किञ्चित् गणयति विदितं ते अस्तु तेनास्मि दत्ता वृत्तेभ्यः श्रीनियोगात् गदितुम् इव गता इति सो दट् श्रीनियोगात् should also come before, he says, right? Shri Niyogat Gaditumiva Gata. Let's see what he says there. Lagnam Ragavritangya Ityado Iti Shri Niyogat Iti Vachyam, that gaditum eva, iti has come somewhere else. Huh? 1 minute. Ityambodhi. So
Ityambudhim, sir.
Ityambudhim comes at the end, right? So Shri Niyogat gaditum eva, ityambodhim, something comes there. So that iti should come before Shri Niyoga. That is the kramam that should be there. Sari? I am not very satisfied with this, but just learn it as it is. Next is amata parartham. Amataha prakrita viruddhaha parartha. Prakrita viruddhaha. Enna kelvi? Okay. Chari, gata iti ambudim yasya kirtihi. That iti should come before Shriniyogate. Iti Shriniyogate. Gatitimave gata ambudim yasya kirtihi. That can also, if it is within the meter, if it does not violate any meter problems, then it's okay. Meters, any, then it's okay. Amataha prakrita viruddhaha arthaha. Parartaha yatra. So parartaha prakrita viruddhaha. When the contextual artham or the idea which is generally rasa viruddhatvam is what we say. This is from Raghuvamsa in the 11th sargam. During the Tataka Vrittantam, if it is not in context, Rama Manmatha Sharena Tadita Dussahena Hridaye Nishachari Gandhavatu Rudhira Chandana Ukshita Jivitesha Vasatim Jagamasa Atra Prakriti Rase Viruddhasya Shungarasya Venjakaha Aparaha Artaha. When we look at the whole meaning of that shloka, par aparaha artaha paraha artaha, what is the other meaning that is reflected? If that is not in, if it is not conducive to the prakrita rasam, then it is called amata parartham. Okay, parartha, if it is amataha, mataha, that which is acceptable or that which is in accordance with the present prakaranika rasam. If it is prakrita viruddham, prakaranika rasa vyanjaka viruddham vartat, or viruddha rasa vyanjaka ha chet, then இட் இஸ் அமத பரார்த்தம் ஸ்லோகா ஹியர் இஸ் ராம மன்மத சரேண நிஷாச்சரி ஹிருதயே தாடிதா துஸ்ஸஹேன துஸ்ஸஹேன so Rama uses his bow arrow to kill Tataka, and during that Tataka vadham, the description that Kalidasa gives here is Rama manmatha sharena. Rama is like a manmatha, so with his shara, with his arrow, nishachari tadita, the rakshasi was hit by his arrow, which is dussahena, which is difficult to tolerate. And where was she hit? She was hit in her heart. Hrudaye nishachari tadita gandhavat rudhira chandana ukshita. Gandhavat, gandhavat, it has a durgandhatvam, gandhayuktam. Rudhira chandanam, rakta chandanavat, athava rudhirameva chandanamatra. Rudhirena ukshita sa nishachari, ukshita vyapta, sikta. She was completely drenched with her own blood, like as if she was drenched by chandanam, which was gandhayuktam. Gandhayuktam, which had a very putrid smell and a very rancid, or a very, putrid is the correct word, I don't know, very bad smell. So the rudhiram, the blood that had a very bad smell, it was completely drenching her, like how chandanam was put on top of her. Jeevitesha vasatim sa jagama. She went to her husband's place. Her husband was Sunda, who was already dead. And Sunda's wife is Tataka. And he, that Rama Sharena, because of Rama Sharena Tadita, because she was hit by Rama's arrow, Tataka went to her husband's place. That is, she also died. So, Jeevitesha Vasatim Jagama. The idea here is actually Bibatsa Rasam. That is your Prakruta Rasam. Whereas Viruddha Rasa, Shringara Rasa is being suggested here. How can we interpret it? The other meanings of all these are Rama Manmatha Sharena, as if hit by Manmatha's arrow, which is very difficult to tolerate. Manmatha's arrow is tough to take the effects of Manmatha, and that Manmatha's Shara comes and hits in the heart. So Hridaye Tadita Sati, and she, because she is under the influence of Manmatha, she anoints herself with Chandana and goes to her beloved's house. Jeevitesha Vasatim Jagama. She goes to her husband's house or her beloved's house because she is not able to tolerate the effects of Manmatha. So she anoints herself. So she dresses herself, decorates herself in Chandanam and goes to her husband's house. So that is the description. That is the Vyanjakam that is there, which is a Viruddharasam. Shringara and Vibhatsa are Viruddharasam. You cannot have those two together. Shringara, Vibhatsa, Tata, Veera Bhayanakau. Gneya, Shringara, Vibhatsa, Tata, Veera Bhayanakau. Raudra, Adbhuta, Tata, Hasya, Karuna, Vairino, Mata, Mitaha. Even if it is an Angarasam, it should be portrayed in such a manner that it is an Anga. Here the Vachyam is Bibhatsam. And because of the words that are given here, it gives rise to Shringara. Actually, the it's tough to, because the person here is Rama, who is a young boy, and he is killing, he is not yet married. He is killing Tataka. The situation is also not of, you know, say for example, if you look at Shurpanaka, you can also have a Shringara and Bibhatsa together in those two at that point. Because she is approaching Rama with the Shringara Rasam, but Rama looks at it with Bibhatsa. Then those two Viruddha Rasa can go together. This is what we read in Auchityam, Auchitya Vichara. Even if it is a Viruddha Rasa, so a Muni, a sage can look at both Shringara, Bibhatsa and Shantarasa at the same time, and that is Rasa Sankaram. Rasa Sankaram is a topic that has to be handled very carefully, even though it is Kalidasa. Here, that Shringara need not have come in here. If he had used this in Shurpanaka's, here Tataka is also not approaching him with the Shringaratva. She is going to her husband with Shringara. She is actually approaching death, and the description is more of a Bibhatsa. I hope you catch the ஐடியா ஹியர். ராம மன்மத ஷரேண தாடிதா துஸ்ஸகேன ஹிருதய நிஷாச்சரி கந்தவது ருதிர சந்தன உக்ஷிதா ஜீவிதேஷ வசதிம் ஜகாமச. அத்ர பிரகிருதே ரசே பிரகிருத பீபத்ஸே ரசே விருத்தஸ்ய ஸ்ருங்காரஸ்ய வியஞ்சகஹ அபரஹ அர்த்தஹ. சோ தட் இஸ் தோஷத்வம் ஹியர். எதர் நீரசத்வம் ஆர் சஹிருதயானாம் வைமுக்கியம். தீஸ் ஆர் த டிஃபரண்ட் வாக்கியமாத்திர தோஷாக தட் வி சா. ஃப்ரம் நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் வி வில் லுக் இட் அர்த்த தோஷாக. தேர் ஆர் அபவுட் 23 அர்த்த தோஷாஸ் தட் ஹி மென்ஷன்ஸ் ஹியர். தேர் மே பி அதர் கிளாசிபிகேஷன்ஸ் விதின் த தோஷாஸ் ஆல்சோ. வி வில் கோ டு தட் நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ். ஓகே.